Okay, today I'm going to go over armor for mount, a common mistake, and how to fix it. Lay down, please, okay? So, I'm going to go explain very basic, like the idea is this. So, you turn a bit sideways to make my armbar easier. So people get to all the effort of going to the position where they can actually go for the armbar, to the Z mount or S mount, whatever you call it. They actually get here, and now what they always do, often is taught, is to step over their head. Now, I don't see any point whatsoever why I would step over the head. For one, what is the problem? Look, if I do step over, one, the chances are there that Latif can put his hand behind my leg, see? Keep the arm tight, Latif, maybe even cross your hand into your elbow. I would lay down, and as I go down, push my leg with your, push your leg with your right arm, yeah? With your left arm, push. See, and it's going to be very hard to get his back. And it will start going up. Get on top. And now I'm stuck. And often I will lose the arm bar. So the problem with the leg is, okay, look, if I want to do an arm bar, I want to bring his hand far away from his face, right? So the idea of pushing into that face with your leg and keeping the arm away, that is sound, but I don't like the fact you have to push. There's a better way to do it. So what I do, pull a bit more over here, please. Yeah. So what I do, once I get to Z mount, I always like to put my knee underneath the head. So in mount, head control is a big thing. If he keeps his head on the floor, he can always walk away that side. Walk away, please. Walk straight. And it will put me lower into his mount. And our baby bridge. Here. And it would make it hard for me to stay because I'm on this hip. So I always want to stay as high as possible. So for this reason, I like to control the head. And I put my knee behind his head to keep it tight. See? And now try to move, please. It's like a stack. If you curve his spine, if you put his nose toward his butt, he's always going to be stuck. Now, if I control the arm here, it makes it very hard for you to put an arm bar from here. Keep your arm please tight a bit. So, first of all, to talk about which direction is better. So, I could fall backwards through the arm bar, or I could go forwards for the arm bar. I always prefer to go forward for a reason I will explain in a second. So, I think from here, if I start pushing your knee, my knee or fit, keep your arm tight. Just pushing your face up. It's likely you're gonna fight to get it back. Put your hand on the floor, please. Once he puts you on the floor, put it. Yeah. I'm gonna put my shin into his face. See now, push your head up. I push your hand to my leg. See, this maintains this is way better. So even if I would fall from here and control the leg, so try to bring your head close to me. It's harder, right?
Yeah.
Try to put your hand underneath my knee. That can still be done kinda, but it's way more different than see, push my leg away, that's hard. Push it away now, that's easy, see? So I prefer always to keep my shin inside his face. That's one. And two, I prefer to do the arm bar, I'll go a bit more over here. I prefer to do the arm bar, always facing away from my partner. If you see any of my instructionals, you know that the baby bridge is a very big thing in my game. It comes back in defense, but also very much in offense. So for those who don't know the baby bridge, start from rock bottom, arch your back, look away, bring your head away, and look sideways. See, this would be the baby bridge. If you want more information about that, you can check my instructionals on BJ Fanatics or some of my other videos on this channel. Now, what is this important? Look, if I just raise my hips straight in the middle, this is as high as I get. My head is a limiting factor, my neck stays bent. Okay, so this is quite high, but not as high as it could be. Now if I go baby bridge, see, my hip goes way higher and I have more strength to do it. I can also move better from this position. So, the same with a sprawl. A sprawl in the middle is actually, this motion will be the sprawl. This is the same thing as the bridge. It's the same motion when my head is stuck when I'm on the floor. So here I can sprawl. Now, in order for the sprawl to be effective, I need to get my hip close to the floor. It's more effective if I look over one shoulder, start turning in one hip. So now I can reach this leg. So you're already going to see a good, initially, a good rest of my sprawl here. But usually it starts to turn into him sliding away. And at some point, getting one hip to the floor. It's way more effective. So now we're going to apply this to the arm bar. So, I got to Z mount. I trapped his head. I have the arm already. He gets his head to the floor. Post my shin into his face. One thing I learned always is from Chris Houter. He always says, When you're on top, stay on top. Exactly. So if I lay down, I'm actually breaking the rule. I'm actually going down. So I prefer to be on top. So what I want to do is instead of feet arm type of lift, instead of pulling the arm, see, I like to put a rotation on by looking away, see, putting my weight on my right hand, my posting hand, look away, so to make a rotation right away. See here, I can actually finish the armor right away. Try to go up on this. If not, this starts to go up, keep going. Keep looking away, and I go for the reverse arm right away here. See, Latif, try to move. This is a way easier finish. I can finish from here, and if Latif would roll over his shoulder, I can follow up, and I still end up in the same position where I would have ended up in the beginning. So go back. If I would have laid straight back down. So let's go here. Put your hand in the center. Yeah, here. So I'm not going to go over these setups, but we go over the C-mount alone. And by the way, I never put my toes on that because my toes are not flexible. But if you can, it's probably better to put your toes. It just hurts the hell for me. This might be also one of the reasons why I prefer to lean forward in the beginning. So catch the arm, put your hand on the floor, lean forward, put your shin into his face. I don't keep tapping it, don't pull. I'm making a rotation. And I'm trying to put the lock from top already. See? Now, but this will start to roll. Get up, and he goes, I catch the leg right away, and from here, I can actually finish the arm bar. If it's good, most likely you're going to roll again. Okay. I follow, go sideways, control the leg, sit up the arm bar. 9 times of them start going up at this point, when he goes up with his head, that's when I put my knee behind, and can actually close the triangle with one or both hands. That's the most important part right now. I also, last part, to the center again. So head here. Even if, so when would I go backwards in the beginning? It's really, it's his reaction to my initial position. So if I go here, I push, now if my hip starts to walk backwards here, rotate in. Yeah. See, if I do fall, I can grab the leg, and again here, the same motion would be applied a little bit pulling, I would look away and make the arm bar a rotation. And the lock is right away there, so don't make it a pull. Where it comes up, so maybe this is maintain this is with my chin, keep the arm against my chest, look away, and then from here, look away, see, start rotating. That's it. And if you start completely from here in the beginning, again, this is okay. If you control your legs like that, that's fine. There's not a lot of space for him to get inside. But I would never go from here. This part is dangerous. Put your arm underneath, that's the problem. So if you're already here, both legs crossed and trap the arm, that's fine. Just don't untie them, and don't go from here stepping over, because that's when you lose the position. So if you have the arm loose, again, it ties back to the video I already made about the weakest link principle. So be sure, in the end, I will put a button where you can check that video out to make yourself tight. Go sideways. See, I open my elbow, put my hand, my hip as a lever. Then, when I start rotating, put my foot close to his face, look away, and I'm going to rotate up. See, look, keep tight, look at that. So if I rotate, put my elbow is a lever, and then start to open his arm. When it's completely straight, I slide up, and I can actually finish the arm bar from here right away. So try to go up like this. Exactly. And even if you force yourself up, man, really force yourself up, you push towards me and here, then I still have the arm, and I can finish. So try to apply this concept in your arm bar. I promise you it will work, and just apply big reaches everywhere into your game. It will increase everything, well, make everything way more effective. Hope you like, hit that like button, make sure to subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions, please reply in the comments. And a challenge for you would be, find more ways how you can implement the big reach into your game. Tag me in some videos, or if you have questions about certain positions and how the day reach and this concept can make it better, just tell me and I will make a video about that. Thanks a lot.